So let's move ahead and see what are the new things that we can explore, quote unquote.
It's really refreshing having a tea in front of the tea garden only. This is the tea. Serene weather, but very cold. Very cold. Very, very cold. We are going to reach the top and try to see whether Kanchanjanga will be visible or not. So we are moving. My friend is going crazy. See, we have almost reached it, and now this is the view. Now, a bit is visible. With the naked eye, it's beautiful. But in the camera, I guess it's coming very small. I need to take a video using my DSLR so that you can have a greater look over here. So this is on top. We have come on top. Like, we have left our bike downstairs. And then you saw that we have climbed this one, and now we have reached over here. From there, we will be exploring more. This is the view. My hands are shaking as because it's quite cold over here. And this has gone too far. Trees, covered up trees and all. And a bit of other mountain. That's the head. That's the body. And the rest of the part will be seen from the other end. That's because trees are covering up. Nepal is situated right in the left hand corner of my hand, and we are going to follow this road. So we have reached this place. As you can see, the sleeping Buddha is, you can see the nose, and that's the mouth, that's the body, and he is still lying over there. Everything is visible. The sun is quite shining at the top of my head, and it's a very pleasant weather. It's a bit cold. We thought that the area will be covered up by fog, but then we are very lucky to have reached over here without any delay. By my watch, it's 11:37. And after this, we are planning to go more, and we'll be having a clear look. But I'm not sure that after this, whether I'll be having a clear look or not. But then you can see the beauty of this one. that Sandafu. And it takes already like, I was talking to a person, he was telling that it takes already 10 days. And just like to reach that point, and if you can see, that's Manebhanjang, that's the village. We have to go for a permit, and that's the narrow road which follows on top over here. That's Chitrey. And then from here, it takes like walking, it takes like 10 days. And that's the beauty, as you can see, the sleeping Buddha. We are taking a road, this one goes to Manebhanjang. This is a shortcut which goes straight. Quite steep, isn't it? Very, very slippery. All because of the fog. Like it was quite drizzling early in the morning. Everything was like getting drenched by this weather. So slowly we are trying to reach that village which is down, and from there we'll try to reach Chitrey. That's the view. We are talking with a few brothers over here. Manebhanjang is quite near, so we are coming to know about the location, and from these two brothers we are coming to know. We do not know about the road, so that's why we are taking this road. So let's see what's over there. And these brothers are helping us. They are local, living over here only, and they are going up. We have taken a very steep road. This is not the road that we are supposed to take, but anyone who is coming, don't take this road, as because it's very steep and highly dangerous. So it's better you take the other road which goes directly to that village, Manebhanjang. This is 2 kilometer road, but if you take a risk, then it's quite slippery and it's also broken in most of the places. So still, by walking, by and all this means, we have taken this road, and Manebhanjang is quite near only. So that's Manebhanjang, and from there we'll be having our lunch and then we'll go. So we're going to have our lunch, and we have just parked our bike over there in the back, and now we are falling towards the market. This is the market. This is sab cholbe. This is Hotel Pradhan
in Manebhanjang.
In Manebhanjang.
Otherwise people will not know where it is.
Already the description has been given.
Given, okay, I was not aware.
Yeah, we have been like doing early from morning on it, so. So, finally we had our lunch, and we are going to leave this place. Wonderful memory. We are quite lucky, like, it's getting foggy, as because by my watch it's 1:36. So cold weather, and from here we'll take the route of Darjeeling, ghoom, and then we'll come down to Siliguri and back to our home. So let's go and have a ride. So finally we have reached Kurseong, and after this we have halted in one of the restaurants.
just to chill ourselves. And since it's very cold, we are going to have coffee and momo. And then we'll head straight towards our home. This is a nice restaurant. Small passage in this way, and maybe that's the family restaurant. It's inside. We did not choose this one is because this place is quite serene and it's empty also. So anyway, we'll be having our evening meal, and after that we'll move on. And it's really very, very cold. So slowly we'll depart towards our home, and that's the end of the journey. But quote unquote, we had a wonderful journey over here.